Yashata. For angels have even been dispatched from Africa right now. Africa right now. Africa right now. From Africa right now.
Yashata. For angels have even been dispatched from Africa right now. Africa right now. Africa right now. From Africa right now.
This lady, Paula, Paula White? You know, said all the angels from Africa are supposed to be in America right now to help Trump. I hear nothing about this, bro. What's up with this? I meant Trump denied our visa because we're from Africa, so we can't come and help him with the election. I don't know, man. I'm about to call Gabrielle up and see what's going on, because, man, we got to get to this. You heard what she said, man. We're supposed to be there right now. Let me call the South American angels, too. Hey, beautiful people, welcome to This Beautiful Crazy Life podcast. Make sure to hit that notification bell, subscribe, like, and share. Wait 1 second here. I have these two beautiful discount, very on sale candles. They still smell great to set the mood. And I thought they're appropriate since Paula White was doing that very strange chanting. Now, who exactly was that in the video? That was Paula White. Paula White is Donald Trump's spiritual advisor. She is a pastor, a preacher, and a televangelist. Been around for quite some time and has quite a significant following. Just looking on her Instagram, she has over 500,000 subscribers. Now, where Paula White lies in the Christian theological framework, I'm not really sure. Some people just say she's a heretic. Some people say she's a Pentecostal. And some people say she is an American prosperity preacher. For me, from what I can give the information and what I've seen of her, she definitely falls into that latter as an American prosperity preacher. I want to focus on something that kind of plagues the church in a lot of ways, and is that America is sort of the center of what God cares about the most. I think a lot of people, whether they are Calvinist, Arminian, Catholic, who reside in America, sort of think America's the center of the world when it comes to the Christian church. I mean, think about so much of what is said in among many evangelical circles, that if Donald Trump doesn't win, then America suffers and the world suffers. It's very absurd in the end of the day, right, to think that angels from Africa and South America are going to come in, right, and then help the election of Donald Trump. When I guess they could be doing other things like helping starving children or failing economies or conflict or disease. You know, the things that plague many lower development countries. But instead, God is so concerned that Paula White says the African angels are on their way right now. I'm not exactly sure how that works. I don't know if angels come all over from Africa and then they, like, I don't know, become registered voters and then somehow vote in places they never lived before. Or maybe they just make ballots magically appear. Or maybe they destroy all the Democrats, Democrats, and expose them how evil they exactly are. A lot of times I'm not really clear what Paula White was praying for exactly. There's so many things that I find very crazy about this video. First, that she believes she has some special revelation between her and God. So special, in fact, that she knows angels from Africa and South America are on their way right now to help Donald Trump get elected. The other thing that I have such an interesting idea is that so many evangelicals believe that Donald Trump is necessary to complete the plans of whatever God has in store. The other thing I find even more interesting is, like, what's up with this dude in the background of this video? What is he doing? I don't know what's going on.
Reinforcement ending. I hear the sound of victory. I hear the sound of victory.
But this whole video is just so strange. It shows some of the problems of American-centric Christianity, and it shows some of the problems with prosperity preaching. I think many American Christians just think that America is this chosen place. And I want to end this video with this, and it's something that Matt Chandler said. Matt Chandler, take the way.
The United States of America, for all the beauty that she has and has accomplished, is a bit player in God's story. She is not God's story. She is a bit player in it. He was active and moving and saving and driving out darkness long before her, and he'll be doing that long after her. This is indisputable. And yet I think so many of us see, like, we bought into Reagan. We're the city on a hill. No, we're not. Church of Jesus Christ is the city on the hill. We're the light of the world. We are not the light of the world. Do I think we're the best that human beings can do? Yes. If there's a God we mutually submit to, yes. Are we the hope and light of the world? Good Lord, please. Please don't think that. Please don't think that. Are we the best man has come up with to date? I think so. But we certainly aren't the light of the world. That's just ridiculous. So,
hey, I hope you guys liked that video. Make sure to press the like and subscribe button. As I said earlier in the video, I gotta say it several times, that call for action is a very important thing for public speaking. And also next week I'm having a video come out. It's gonna be about American pastors and preachers who predict the election of Trump. This one's an interesting one. I think you guys are going to enjoy it. Anyway, I'll see you guys later. Peace.